Unimilk. Water. Baby cereal.
Cereal, right? Mm-hmm. How much of that are you using?
Probably half. Okay, water. The mix has to be like not too watery or not too, what's it called?
Thick.
Not too thick. Okay, you add more. Yes, that's okay. It's water.
It's too watery. You should add a little bit more cereal, thicken it up.
So
the consistency is better now that you added a little bit more of rice. Baby cereal, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's Blanca. That's gonna be our keeper female. She is a lilac and tan covered in cream. She's a platinum. She is a merle. You do not see any merle markings because she is white or cream. This is her first time getting introduced to Mush. I think you saw it's just a mixture of baby cereal, a little bit of Unimilk, which is milk for all species, and a little bit of water. First time trying it out. Right now she is 3.5 weeks of age. The whole litter is 3.5 weeks of age. These puppies are off of our girl Bella, bred to Bingo. They have been doing amazingly. They are just a few days behind schedule. They aren't teething yet, all that great. So what happens there is if their teeth are now, they're not really wanting to munch. They're still wanting to suckle. And the problem with that is aspiration risk is just a lot too high. So right here, you see them wanting to munch a little bit more. And that is a good sign, because you do not want them to try to suckle on this. You do not want it to go at the wrong pipe and have them aspirate food. So during this process, you definitely do want to be patient. As you see, this little girl's getting spoon-fed. Gets a little tedious, it gets a little messy. So if you are as lucky as I am, my good helper right here, my wife Yahaira. I have a great team behind me. Couldn't be doing what I do without them. Whether it's my wife or my daughters. But everybody puts in the work and everybody has the same love for the dogs, which is amazing. It's one big thing that binds us together. I think she's kind of down. She's not really too much interested all that much in the food anymore. We're just going to wipe the little bit of excess food that she has around her mouth. With the baby cereal, you have to be really careful for to have any of it around them in excess, just because it does give them a little bit of a rash. So you want to make sure they get cleaned up after every feeding. Yeah, she looks pretty full. And it won't take that much, as it's a very solid food. They will get full pretty quick. Right here we have a little blue and tan Merle boy, Marble. Same thing. First time getting introduced to Mush. Let's see how he does. You gotta feed the puppy. He's trying to eat off the bowl. that old blue and tan male. He has like a little goatee going on. Fell belly. Here we have Frosty. He's a blue cream. Let's see how this boy does. Probably stole one's mama's titty. Said nope, spoon don't feel natural. Not everybody,
there we go.
Or not every pup from the litter will always be ready at the same time. Sometimes even takes a feeding, sometimes it even takes a day. This guy right here is already trying to munch on the spoon right now. But we have had many instances where the pups are not wanting to actually munch on the food. They're still trying to suckle down.
Okay, got it.
Sorry about the autofocus. Right now the puppies look okay. But now that they're gonna start eating on their own, I mean, they're gonna look a lot better than just being on off of mom's milk. With proper nutrition and supplementation, in the next 2 weeks, they will look like totally different Frenchies. Again, all the excess must be wiped down. You don't want any tire irritation going on from a little bit of excess rice. Make sure everything's wiped down clean. Simple to do. A little burp. Back to the litter box we go. Now this is little Olaf. Last but not least. He is also a blue cream. He is the smallest out of the litter. See how he does. He wanted to munch out of it out of the edge of that bowl, so. Yeah, buddy. Usually we start trying to do mush at 3 weeks, but these puppies still did not have any teeth. We're not teething yet at all, so we give them a few extra days. Definitely paying off, as you can see right here. You're not struggling trying to force feed them some mush or anything like that. They're going at it fully on their own. It looks all awkward just being in the bowl. He's very, very tiny, but he looks a lot more awkward than he really is, especially the way he's just really getting in there. But like I mentioned before, now he's gonna be able to get the proper nutrition. And we're gonna put him on a high calorie diet on all of them. Make sure that they're going to be gaining the way they're getting the nutrition that they need, the supplementation, add multivitamins, probiotics, everything to their diet to ensure proper growth. For the first run, the holder did amazing.
Really hungry. It's okay. Mm.
Munch running carb coma over here. Everybody did great. They love their baby cereal, their milk. And within the next few days, they should be having a little bit of puppy kibble also added to the mix. And that is the best way to try to get them to start eating on their own. Another thing that also helps is, like I mentioned earlier, we didn't push it at 3 weeks. A lot of people want their puppies to start eating mush at 3 weeks. Sometimes it takes 4 weeks. Like you see right here, they're only a few days shy of 4 weeks of age. And we waited. They still didn't have any teeth. They were still trying to suckle versus trying to chomp down on the food. So sometimes it just pays off to wait. Another thing, even if they are eating on their own now, they will still be getting at least 1 to 2 feedings off of their mom. That does not do anything bad for them. They love mom's milk. It's natural for them to have mom's milk. So we will keep them on that. If you guys have any questions, any type of concerns or anything, drop them in the comments, send us an emails. Information is in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you guys for watching.